Hello, in this video we'll show an example of how IBM App Connect can create different structures of data. For this example, we'll be taking a set of products from one system and using them to create a CSV file. So you can see here in Salesforce I have my list of products, which in this case happen to be flowers, and each of them has a product code which is made up of two letters and four numbers, and then a product family, so bulbs or seeds and so on. So here in App Connect, to start with, we'll create a simple event-driven flow. And in this case, I want to create my CSV file on a schedule. So I'll go into the toolbox and create a schedule. And we'll set it to run every hour, and also when the flow has first been switched on. So now we'll go to Salesforce and find products, and then retrieve our products. And in this case, I only want to retrieve the seeds from the set of flowers. So I'll select the product family and set that to be seeds. And I'll retrieve up to 100 items. Then we'll go to Box, which is where we'd like to create the CSV file, and select Create File. And then choose the folder that we'd like to put the CSV file into. So first of all, I'll set my file name to be Products, and also give a timestamp of now to make sure that each CSV file has a unique name. So then we'll select CSV as the file content type, and then provide a short sample from which we'll generate the schema. So first of all, we're asked to add the collection of items that will populate the rows of the CSV. In this case, these are our products from Salesforce. And then we'll include the name in each column, and also the code. Now the product code is a single thing in Salesforce, but here we want to split it into two parts, and there's a number of different functions I can use. But in this case, I'm going to use the substring function so that I can pull out the first two characters. And then again, for the code in numbers, I'll include the product code from Salesforce. And again, use the substring function. And this time, pull out the next four characters. And finally, I'll add the created date. Then we'll set the type of the file to be text. And then our flow is ready. So we'll give it a name, and switch it on, and then return back to our dashboard where we can see all of our running flows. So then here we can see in Box that a new file has come through. So when we refresh, we see our new set of products. And then here in the CSV file, we can see the name of each of the flowers, the code split into two parts, and the created date. And here in App Connect, we can also see that everything is well. And that's the end of this demo.